From March 4th to March 24th, the Colorado Avalanche went a perfect 9-0 and had won 11 out of their last 12 games. They were undefeated in their first 7 games since the trade deadline. It looked as though they were going to cruise through the rest of the regular season. However, since their comeback win against Pittsburgh, they are 2-4-1 and have not looked like the same team at all. So, what's gone wrong for the Avalanche over the past 2 weeks? Well, the first problem is one that I'm not going to spend a ton of time on, and that's goaltending. We have talked about it already on this channel, and a lot of fans are blowing it out of proportion and making it a bigger deal than it really is, but it has been a problem. If we can't rely on Georgiev to make saves, then we're going to be a pretty quick out come playoff time, simple as that. Moving on. Another problem as of late has been penalties. The Avalanche seem to be taking unnecessary and undisciplined penalties in recent games. Penalties are part of the game and something that's going to happen from time to time when you're playing hard. However, we've been taking bad penalties that don't need to be taken. We find ways to put ourselves on the kill at the worst possible times, and our penalty kill really hasn't been overly good as of late. We all know how important special teams are come playoff time, and if we end up going into the box like we have been lately, those teams that we have to play in the postseason are going to make us pay for it. Now, those are two of the, I'd say, smaller problems that the Avalanche have. They can get over that goaltending hump, I think, with a hot starter, whether it's Anonin or Georgiev, and the penalties they can fix with some discipline. However, now we're going to get into the ones that might not be quite so easy to fix. Depth has also been a huge struggle for the Avalanche as of late. Although Chris McFarland went out at the deadline and added Brandon Duhaime and Yakov Trenin, it unfortunately hasn't helped much. When comparing our bottom six to Dallas and Winnipeg since March 8th, it's very concerning how bad our depth has been. Since the deadline, our bottom six players have just 20 points combined, compared to 34 for Winnipeg and a whopping 60 for Dallas. Dallas's bottom six players have outscored ours by 3 since the trade deadline. Our bottom six is a combined minus 20, while the Jets are plus 10 and the Stars are plus 31. Yes, the Stars are plus 51 in their bottom six over ours since March 8th. Jamie Benn alone has 1 less point since March 8th than as our entire bottom six. McKinnon, Drouin, and Rantanen can only carry us so far. You need great depth to win in the playoffs, and clearly ours is much, much worse than Dallas and Winnipeg's right now, which is a huge concern heading into the postseason. And once again, that's something that won't fix itself. Unless they wake up and start playing well, we're in for a huge awakening. However, that isn't even the biggest problem. The biggest problem that the Avalanche have right now, and the one that I think is costing them games in a horrific way, is their defensive play. The Avalanche spend way too much time playing in their own zone and are leaving way too many opposing players wide open. In the last 3 games, Colorado has given up 130 shots on goal, 46 in Minnesota, 47 in Edmonton, and 37 to Dallas. Now, this isn't just on the defensemen, as I mentioned how bad our depth has been defensively, but they are a huge part of the problem. It all starts, for me at least, noticing a huge thing. It all starts on opposing dump-ins, as our defensemen are lazy, slow, and weak when we're getting back on puck retrievals. This gives opposing teams the opportunity to beat us to pucks and set up a forecheck. And for a team that likes to play north and south like Colorado, that's just a disaster waiting to happen. Even Makar and Toews are giving up pucks and turning it over way too much in our own zone. On our breakout, we just try to ring the puck up to one of our wingers and hope that our center can come through and sweep it up. This isn't going to work for an entire 7-game series, as teams that are in the playoffs are going to figure out a way to neutralize that, just like Dallas did on Sunday. Let's look at a few of these breakdowns here. Here on Dallas' first goal of the game from Sunday, Sam Girard makes an errant pass that Nathan MacKinnon is unable to grab. Josh Manson way overcommits to the strong side of the ice on Dallas' regroup, and Chris Tanev finds Matt Duchene, who slipped behind Manson, and he's now way out of position. Georgiev's a little too far out of his net, and it's a complete breakdown by the entire group. Boom, 1-0 Dallas. On the second goal, it all starts up top as Asa Lindell is left wide open because Joel Kiviranta and Brandon Duhaime, two of our wingers, are below the goal line. That's not where they're supposed to be. Lindell gets the puck over to Wyatt Johnston, and even though his stick breaks, our wingers are so out of position that no one's up top, and Lindell's the first to the puck, and Jamie Benn is left wide open on the far side of the net as Sean Walker is out covering nobody at the top of the circles. Another full unit breakdown for the Avalanche. Now, the next two are on the penalty kill, which is obviously a little tougher to defend, but again, that ties into our penalty problem as of late. However, on Roope Hintz's goal here, Devontaes is in the lane, but moves over to take the puck carrier. However, Cale Makar completely forgets to slide over and cover Hintz as he is left wide open streaking down the middle of the ice towards the net, which is just going to be a goal every time. Boom, back the net. The fourth goal isn't much of a breakdown as it is just a good play by Dallas, but the fifth one once again is, as Mason Marshman gets forgotten down in the corner and beats Sam Girard back to the net and tips it in. This one isn't quite as bad as, again, we're still on the penalty kill, which makes it tough for our D to pick up everything that's happening, but we still need to try to keep everything out of the front of the net as much as possible. Now, the sixth goal is an absolute killer as it took away pretty much any hope that the Avalanche had of making a comeback. The puck gets moved to Stankoven in the corner, but nobody goes to him. Manson takes Jamie Benn in front of the net, and Sam Girard has Wyatt Johnston at the top of the circles, so Casey Mittelstadt is in charge of getting to Stankoven over in the corner. But he gives him all sorts of time and space, he plays very, very far back, which allows Benn to get open and Johnston to sneak into the crease and put the puck in. Mittelstadt needs to go straight to him, pressure him, but instead he gives him time, he's very relaxed on the defensive play, and it ends up in the back of our net. Another penalty kill here, as this one's from the game last Thursday against the Minnesota Wild, and Mikko Rantanen, who granted is not a penalty killer, gets sucked down to the goal line while Zuccarello is looking for Kaprizov. Now we have three out of our four guys below the circles with only one Wild player in front of the net. Kaprizov's not going to score from right there, and Rantanen needs to stay at the hash marks to take away a lane for a pass to come up top. Because Mikko's down low, Kaprizov moves it to a wide open Chisholm, who has all sorts of time and space and gets the exact shot he wants. We are unable to clear Eric's neck out in front of the crease, which allows him to take away any view Anderson has of the puck. Boom, goal right there. The final goal that we're going to look at here is one from the Columbus game. Manson gets the puck at the point, but throws it right into the Columbus defender. Once he gains control, we start puck watching, which leaves their far side winger wide open, and he shoots up the ice to get open, gets the cross ice pass, and he's able to walk in with pretty much as much time and space as he wants. There were many defensive breakdowns in this game, but we won't go over that. What worries me about these breakdowns in the D-zone coverage is that it's not something that just suddenly clicks for teams. This has to be drilled into the players' heads from day one. They have to know exactly who their man is and where they need to be. But right now, the Avalanche just look lost every time they're trying to defend. This is on Bednar and the coaching staff, as they've had all season to get this through, but we're still awful. Too many times we're undisciplined in chasing pucks rather than staying home. The chances of our defensive play getting drastically better are very low, as like I said before, it's not something that just happens. This takes time to practice and develop, and time is just something that we no longer have. Overall, I'm very concerned about this team right now, as all Avalanche fans should be. We all know that our first round opponent is going to be the Winnipeg Jets. After the loss to Dallas, we pretty much have fallen out of the race for the Central Division. We're going to be playing Winnipeg in round one, and if we do win, we'll most likely have to play Dallas in round two. Right now, and really all season, Winnipeg and Dallas have been much more structured, more disciplined, and a deeper team than the Avalanche. I honestly 100% don't see us beating Winnipeg in the first round if this continues, and even if we do beat them, there's no way in hell we beat Dallas. Something needs to be fixed quick, or this is going to be a very, very short playoff appearance for Colorado. I don't mean to be so negative in today's video. Obviously, it's not a very positive one, but there's so much talent on this team, and it is a deeply built team. They have the potential to win a Stanley Cup, but it frustrates me that we're playing so undisciplined and so bad in our defensive zone that we're going to throw everything away. We're going to throw McKinnon's heart season away in the first or second round because we don't know how to play hockey. But with that being said, tell me what you guys think. Do you agree? I'm not necessarily saying that we're done, that we're not going anywhere. I'm just saying if nothing gets fixed, then we're going to have a problem in the playoffs. But with that being said, like I said, tell me what you guys think. What do you think needs to be fixed? What do you want to see stay the same? And just let me know your overall thoughts. I'll catch you next time. Thank you.